How to use address function in Microsoft Excel. Hello everyone, welcome to Excel 10 tutorial. In this function explain video series, I'm going to explain how you can use the address function in Microsoft Excel. What are the parameters of it and how you can use it. Okay, let's get started. Now the best way to learn a function is to apply it, and in this tutorial we are going to apply the address function, and while I am applying it, I am going to explain the parameters of it and how we can use it. Okay, now simply write here equal to address, and you can see here if I click here it says creates a cell reference as text given specified row and column number. Now remember, it will create a cell reference as text, okay, and if you give it a row and column number it will do that. So that's the main thing of address. Okay, so if I double click here, and you can see the first parameter is row number, so give it a row number, it's a numeric value. I am going to write 5, so this is my row number, and if I press comma, and it is asking for the column number, so let's give it 5 again, so this is the column number. Now if I press comma, the rest of them are optional, okay, these are not mandatory, you don't have to apply this, but if you want you can. So if I press comma, it says you want absolute reference, relative reference, or absolute row and relative column, or relative row, absolute column, whatever you want you can choose it. Okay, so I'm going to select relative references, its value is 4. Now if I press comma again, it is asking for the address style. Okay, now which style you want, it's A1 style or R1C1 style. Okay, in A1 that means this style is our usual worksheet reference style. Okay, so if I use this one, it will send me back column name and row number, and if I use R1C1 it will send me back the column number and reference number. I'll talk about references in later on. Now I'm going to select the usual one, A1 style. Now if I press comma, I can add the sheet number, okay, sheet text. So if I write here, and obviously I will have to write within double quotation, so if I want the address from sheet 2, I can do it here. If I need to add the workbook name, I can write the workbook name before the worksheet name within third bracket. Okay, so now I'm going to close the parentheses. So all our parameters are ready, our function is ready, and if I press enter, you can see it has given me sheet name and the cell number, which is E5, and it is in A1 reference style. Okay, so this is how address function works. Okay, so you provide row number and column number, and address function will give you the cell number or the cell addresses. Okay, so this is how address function works, and this is what I wanted to show you. Thank you, thanks for watching, see you in the next tutorial. If you can, please support the channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.